We have been talking about a topic, prepare the way. There is nothing that you will become without preparation. There is nothing you can achieve without starting somewhere. The way you lay your foundation, that is how the building will stand. The Bible tells us that when we lay our foundation on the sand, he said that when the wind blows, that the wind blows and scatter the house because the foundation was not on a solid foundation. It was on sand. He said, but when the foundation of our life, when we prepare it upon the solid rock, we make the foundation, build the house upon the rock. He said, no matter how the storm is, he said, the house will still be standing. Your future is in your hands. Your present is in your hands. What you are going through today is as a result of what has happened or what the way you have prepared yesterday. Even to our health, to common things, we eat bad food, we receive bad health. Not mean that we should be extra conscious, but that we should eat wisely. We exercise, we have good bodies. The same way we should exercise our mind. Amen. It's making boom boom. Can we just reduce it a little bit so that we can enjoy it? Amen. Why are my grandchildren crying today? Are you growing another? You see, he's looking at me immediately. I said it. He turned to look at me. Are you growing another teeth? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Better day. Stop that. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Amen. Heaven and earth adore me. The angels bow before me. What a mighty God. Before he puts man there, he did not just throw man on earth and ask man to start cultivating. He prepared what man will cultivate. He taught man how to name the animals. He gave man the wisdom on how to relate even with the animals, with the fish, with the birds, with the sea, with the soil, with everything. He gave man everything. He prepared the way for the future so that he is very sure that what he has spoken, just as he said unto us, that I will make you to reach your expected end. According to the book of Jeremiah 29:11. He wants us to see that he has put everything in place that will enable us to reach that expected end. So when he said unto Adam and Eve, be fruitful and multiply, take dominion, fill the earth, he knows that it is possible because he has already prepared everything. Even the wealth, the prosperity, the riches. I can have the other one if this one is given. The Bible tells us that because of what God has said, that God said, I am taking you to a land that is flowing with milk and with honey. Then we are on the journey to that land, which God has promised to give them. After Joseph, which we talked about last week, after they have been in Egypt, which Joseph went to prepare for the Israelites, now it is a time for them to come out of Egypt. They came out of Egypt and then they are in the wilderness. And now it is the time for them to go and possess their possession. According to what God has promised Abraham, God said, all the land that you have sojourned, Abraham, I will give it unto you for inheritance. So God already gave them Egypt for inheritance, because Abraham sojourned in Egypt. Abraham also sojourned in Canaan. Abraham also passed through Jericho. Now it is for them to go. But for them to go to Jordan, there was a sea, the sea of Jordan, that was blocking, that was in between. As it was a stumbling block between them and Jericho that they will pass by. Every time in our life, when we are going through the way, when we are going to achieve something, there is always one barricade or another barricade. There is one hindrance or another hindrance. There is one stumbling block or another stumbling block. There is no time you pass through the way that you pass through the way smoothly. But in Christ Jesus, God has given you and I the power, the strength, the mind, the intelligence, the wisdom, the knowledge and understanding that always make there to be a way where there seems to be no way. Because he said, I am Jesus. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father. That means no one comes to his blessing. No one comes to his prosperity. No one comes to his glory. No one comes to his breakthrough except by me. Because in my Father's house, there are many mansions. So when he tells you no one comes to the Father except by me, that means that the blessings of the Father, which has already eradicated any cause of the enemy, which has already destroyed any foundational problem or generational problem, as long as Jesus is the one that is preparing your way, that is your way, you will achieve that which God has spoken concerning you. So hindrances are always there. Barricades are always there. Stumbling blocks are always there. But those who are in Christ, those who follow the ways of God, there is always a way out. That is why he said in the book of Corinthians, he said, don't say that one temptation or another temptation is falling upon me, and as if I don't know how to come out of it. He said, but in that temptation, there is a way out. Tell your neighbor, there is always a way out. And you will find that way, and you will come out of your problems in the name of Jesus. So I gotta tell you one way that we need to walk, because Jesus has done his own, God has done his own, everything has been prepared, but we have our own path. That is why I said at the beginning that what you are going through today is as a result of yesterday. If your yesterday was well prepared, if you have planned your today with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding yesterday, you will enjoy today. If you are planning poorly, you will suffer some things today. It is just the nature. But that does not mean that we should dwell in our mistakes, but we have opportunity always to change. Joshua 1:3-1, he says that Joshua rose early in the morning, and they removed from Shittim and came to Jordan, he and all the children of Israel, and lodged there before they passed over. There was a focus, there was a goal, there was a place where they were to go. They needed to pass over where? Jordan. But it's so good that God told us that before they passed over. So let us see what happened. And it came to pass after 3 days that the officers went through the host. Can we please continue that at least? Rabo Shiraba. Amen. And they commanded the people, saying, when you see the ark of the covenant of the Lord your God and the priest, the Levites, bearing it, then you shall remove from your place and go after it. I will still come back to this, but let's read 4. Yet there shall be a space between you. Let's jump 4. 5. And Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. Make yourself whole. And Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourself, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. Tell your brother, sanctify yourself. Sanctify yourself. 5. Yeah. Come like, you don't fly. Whoa. Okay. And Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourself, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. Tell somebody sitting by your right and the left, be prepared. For God will do wonders in your life. I am sure of it. Be prepared. For God will do wonders in your life. So we learn from this scripture that they had a focus. They had a journey to go through. They had a place where they needed to reach. And before they passed over, they came to Jordan. And the officers were planning the way they should plan, thinking of what to do, telling themselves, how do we solve this problem? How can I solve this problem? They were meditating. They were thinking about a strategy. They were consulting God because they said that the word of God will pass before them. The ark of covenant will go before them. The promise of God will go before them. That which God has spoken, which the priest carry, which the priest bear, which is the ark of the covenant, which is the word of God. He said, look, just listen to it. Hold on to it. Let it be what you should be looking at. He said, the ark of God go before you. You go after it. Don't go after the ark of covenant, but let it be in your front. Let the word of God be in your front. Let the word of God be your direction. Amen.
Amen.
Am I saying something here? Have you understood something here? Hallelujah. Because that is what is written. He said, they commanded the people, saying, when you see the ark of the covenant of the Lord your God, and the priest, the Levites, bearing it, when you see, when your eyes is able to grasp some understanding of what Rachel is telling you, when you are able to understand it, even as she is bringing it unto you, then something will be motivated and activated in you.
Amen.
That will enable you to get that which belongs to you.
Amen.
And you shall receive it in your mighty name of Jesus. And the key is this. Joshua said to the people, he said, sanctify yourself. What is the meaning of you sanctify yourself? He says, set yourself apart. Make yourself clean. Make yourself holy. Set yourself apart. Know to whom you belong. Know that you are Christ. And Christ is in you. According to the book of Colossians 1, is it 26 or 29? He said, Christ in you, your hope of what?
Glory.
You want to cross the Jordan water? You want to reach your destination? Or you want to jump over the first blockage? Christ in you, your hope of glory. God does not deal with dirty people. I repeat. God does not deal with dirty people. He does not commune with dirty people. He said, what has the temple of God got to do with the temple of Belial? And ye are the temple of the living God. Don't you know that God dwells in you? We can have both of them together. You can have corruption in your body and expect the power and the glory of God to show forth through you. So God is calling on us as we are going into the revival, looking unto God to bless us at the end of this year, looking unto God to Shekinah with us, to dwell with us. He says, sanctify yourself. There is no pride in sin. There is no pride in sin. It's the devil that is proud that is a sinner. You are not a devil. You cannot be proud that you sin. You have to show remorse. It's only the devil that is proud. It's only the wicked soul that is proud when they are doing evil. They kind of say, yes, I know what I'm doing. You are just deceiving yourself. I am deceiving myself if I refuse to follow that which God has spoken. And one of my son was there just to say hello this morning before he went back. And then he said, I told that we come to see you. I said, yes, you were. Immediately came and you people saw him now than the other. I just speak a word of prayer. And I ask him, what is the problem? I've written you so many times. Contacted you through messenger so many times. So many times I see you live on Facebook and I write immediately. I say, Mama, hi. Don't get what I do. Say, I don't want to answer anybody, including me. I said, anyway, no problem. He said, that is why I came now. If I didn't come now, you heard that I came, what will you feel? I said, nothing. I'll be waiting until you change your mind. And when you come, I'll say, welcome, my son. I said, I will not have anything bad about you. We learn that the love of God covers multitude of sin. Do you know how many times I've written him? When Daddy was talking about him yesterday, I opened the words up. I said, Daddy, I've been getting since April till now. I've been writing. I've been sending messages. No response. Then I said, thank God you saw him. And thank God he said he's coming to say hello. What is that thing there for me to now? If he had come in and said, what are you doing? Will you come and get out of this place? How? Who does that one represent? It's not because I'm a pastor that has been who I am. And I always thank God for that. That right from the beginning, my cry is, Father, let my faith be strong. The day that I read Hebrews 11:6 in Nigeria, that scripture never left my brain. But without faith, it is impossible for you to please God. Faith is accepting the word of God for what it is and doing it. That means just agree, whatever he says, do it. And I always tell God, Father, strengthen my faith. Our faith without works is what? Dead. Father, strengthen my faith. When are we going to come to that level of it doesn't matter how you treat me? Let it matter in the eyes of God. Because God is the one that recompenses evil to anyone that does you evil. Don't you know that? Yes. I will show you love. And I will use love to kill the evil. When are we going to come to that extent? He knows I will not send him out. He came with confidence. If I am the kind of person that, they don't know that my character now. Because if you offend, I don't just go near them. If you want to pack 100 people, otherwise people will hear you. Forget that pastor where she be. Don't be so it could be. But I see so, and some people always say it's because of how you behave. That is why people are treating you like that. I say they are not wise. If you are wise, behave the way God said you should behave. If you are wise, behave the way God says what? You should behave. Because there is blessings that follows obedience. There are protections that obedience carries. You ask for the grace. You ask for the wisdom, knowledge, and God will help you. He says, sanctify yourself because tomorrow, why not now? Because tomorrow, God wants to do wonders. So meaning that if you don't cleanse yourself, you don't have the key. If you don't sanctify yourself, if you don't let go the malice, if you don't let go the unforgiveness, if you don't let go the bitterness and the hatred, if you don't let go those things that does not bring glory to God, nor does it bring glory to you, you are not going to assess the wonders that he has prepared. It's my husband family doing me. Because of that, you are not talking to anybody. It's my wife's family. Because of that, you are angry with every one of them. It's your own problem. Not their problem. If they are doing you, he did not say, in the presence of all your enemies, I will garnish a table before you. Why should anyone manipulate you to take their way? Take God's way. And then in their presence, you will be like Peter, who came out of prison, and the prison door will still shut. Am I not talking? Yes. Sanctify yourself, for tomorrow there will be wonders. He sanctified himself, he put himself in God. He came out of prison. And angels opened the door, the guy came out. To make us really know that it was not a dream, nor was it his ghost. He was knocking at the door where they were praying. Rhoda saw him and ran back. All of them that were praying, you see how their faith strong reached. All of them that were praying say, it must be his ghost, not him. They are praying for God to release him. The guy came, they say it's a ghost. The faith disappeared immediately. He kept knocking. They opened the door, Bibles, and they discovered it was Peter. Those who put him in prison said, go and bring him out of the prison. They went there, they said, truly the doors were firmly locked as we locked them, but they were not inside. This is the word of God. Sanctify yourself, and you will come to that place where it is that what they said will become, will never become. What God said will become, that is what we be. Come and say amen to that. If you are not saying no, and everything never ready to change, you don't want to sanctify yourself. Me, I will sanctify myself. By the Spirit of God, His power, His grace, help me, God, to sanctify. Cleanse me so that I will remain to enjoy. Who want to suffer on earth? I'll suffer on earth. Come, go if we can. Go, they be servant. I love Abraham's way. Abraham was a big man here. He got to heaven, big man. And Bible said in Abraham, I am blessed. Let me continue so that I don't divert. Amen. The book of Colossians 3 from 12. Let God be your tabernacle. Let make yourself acceptable to God. That is what the book of Romans says. Make yourself acceptable to God. Do things according to how God said you should do it. I need to do things according to how God said I should do it. Acceptable to God. That God himself will look at it. He said, why you are still thinking about it, I bring it to pass. Don't you know that is a strong relationship, a strong commune with God? That he said that why you are thinking of what you are thinking, I'm bringing it to accomplishment. I've told you of my own story. I look at Joyce Meyer preaching in the computer. And she was advertising her Bible. And I said in my room in Rack and Hour Strasse, 909, 7th floor. That is where we'll be at that time. As I will be attending every nation church. Though the church has said, I said, God, I would really love to have this Joyce Meyer Bible. That was either Tuesday or Wednesday. Got to the church on Saturday. After the church service, somebody gave me Bible. He said, the Lord said I should give you the Bible. I said, thank you, I turned away. When I opened it, I saw it was just my Bible. I screamed. You know that I was so excited. And she was like, what is it? I said, this was exactly what happened. She said, please come and tell my husband, because he didn't believe me. She dragged me to the husband. I said, when she told the husband at home, that God said, he said, you and this your God, where is he? But it was while I was still thinking it. God already told somebody, take your own Joyce Meyer Bible, it was her own, her name was still on it. Take it and do what? Give it to Rachel. Because Rachel just spoke out that she needed the Bible. Give an hand of applause to Almighty God. Not be mean, our God. Amen. So it's when we are saying some things, that is why you have to always clean your mind. When the mind is thinking what is not proper, try. Even as I'm here at times, thoughts that are not good, it comes. I have to carry a clear. I told them sometimes ago when my children were young, when I would hear police, downstairs that they used to go out and come out midnight and all those things. I hear police motor, my heart will make it kick. I will already think unthinkable before I start counseling. So it happens. But practice makes what? Perfect. Colossians 3. He said, put on therefore. This is what God wants. When he's talking about sanctification, when he's asking you to set yourself apart for him, set yourself apart to be holy. He said, put it on, wear it as a clothing, as the elect of God, as somebody who has the choosing of God, as somebody who has said that I belong to God, who you know yourself that God has chosen you to be holy, not only holy, you are his beloved. Hey! Put on therefore as the elect of God, the chosen of God, holy and beloved. God said you are already holy and he loves you. How do you act on your beloved one? It's sweet, muke muke. He said you are beloved. That means he has covered you in his righteousness. But despite the fact that Jesus has died and paid the price, this is what you should choose to do. Don't do evil, but carry yourself powers of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, no pretense, humbleness of mind, meekness, long suffering, forbearing one another, forgiving one another. It's always so funny, some people, I put them to test and they always kind of fail their test. But God will help them. You know, so when I write people 1,000,000 times, they're not going to reply me. But first, if you write me once, I no reply. Ah, I never come to church for 2 times. Why? Because the pastor no reply me. But if you don't reply me 1,000,000 times, no wahala. And I say, when are we going to grow? May God touch every one of us to grow in Jesus' name. Amen. He said, forbearing one another and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Sanctify what? Yourself. For tomorrow, God wants to do wonders. If you prepare your way well, miracles will happen. They will happen in your life. You prepare your way well in God, wonders will happen in your life. He said, and above all things, put on love or charity, which is the bond of perfection. That is what we learned this morning. The bond of perfectness is love. Love covers multitude of sin. Love does not think evil. He does not do anything evil. He said love lasts forever. If actually you have love as God said, love your neighbors as yourself, because he loves every man, you won't be writing down the offense of one person or another against you. Even when the person is not writing you, you're not writing, it doesn't matter. After when you see him, oh, are you well? But from the humbleness of your mind. He shared testimony with me this morning. I was very happy. My joy is to see that things are working well for him. That should be our joy. Not counting. Say, I've written you so then. If only thing, some of them, they will say, that pastor not the ask for anybody. There was somebody that told me that somebody said, nah, I said, look up. I know they ask for that. Okay, see, evidence is. Thank God for what's up. Thank God for messenger. Not this one that came now, another person. Say because of that, he may go another church. Now I say, look, oh, I ask for him. But tomorrow, he will come back. I know them problem. Amen.
Amen.
Love. Love with the humbleness of mind. Is what is an evidence of sanctification. It shows that really you belong to God. You can't belong to God and it is hidden. It's not possible. He said, and above, okay, I've read that. He said, then let the peace, when you sanctify yourself, you will enjoy peace. Let the peace of God do what? Dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Tell your brothers and your sister, whatever you do, in word or in deed, do it in the name of the Lord. If you have that as the rule in your mind and in your heart and in your spirit, you will see that you will be really an example and an evidence of Christ on earth. You can't tell me that when you lie in the name of the Lord. Is it possible?
No.
Uh-huh. No, but they are not doing it in the name of the Lord. You can't tell me when you are doing fornication, you are doing adultery in the name of the Lord. You know that it's not in the name of the Lord yourself. But if you make up your mind to do everything in the name of the Lord, you will sanctify your home to God, sanctify your marriage to God, sanctify your very self to God. Jesus said, Jesus Christ said that for righteousness' sake, he allowed himself to be baptized. Not because he was a sinner. Amen. But because the one that prepared his own way, which is where we pick our monthly topic from, that one that prepared the way for him was doing what baptizing people. And he bowed himself to be baptized, even though he was not a sinner. But to sanctify, I mean to fulfill all righteousness, so that every person we know that is a Christian, we know that it is good to baptize. That is why when we say marry, carry your wife to the church. It doesn't make you shame. Bring your husband to church. When I do church marriage, it doesn't make you shame. It doesn't make person shame. It is actually something that brings glory to God. If you say you love God, do it. Don't commit adultery. Don't commit fornication. Nabati. No hatred. No malice. Now the thing will be saying, it's good now. If you don't do all these things, he brings glory to your life and brings glory to God. Every one of you sleeping, open your eyes. You can't tell me that this preaching that I'm preaching is not sweet enough, or it is not touching enough for you to have your eyes open. Don't meditate when I am preaching. I catch two people. Amen. And when they don't do party, only 1.5 hours for church. Not even they reach 2 hours finished. When we start 11, then you go there, they do after you don't do party. Anyway. Isaiah 51 from 1. Open your eyes. If you know that your eyes is closing, start doing job. When I say shout hallelujah, let your own be the loudest. You will wake up. Amen. Amen. The book of Isaiah 51 from 1. He said, hearken to me, listen to me. No, he don't sleep. Hearken to me, you that follow what? After righteousness. You that you are sanctifying yourself. You that you have made up your mind to sanctify yourself. He said, listen to me. Hearken to me, ye that follow after righteousness. You that seek the Lord, look unto the rock where you are healed, and to the hole of the pit where you are digged. Look unto Abraham your father, and unto Sarah that bear you. For I called him alone, and blessed him, and increased him. Your righteous life will benefit you.
Amen.
Your righteous life will increase you.
Amen.
Your righteous life will make the blessings of God to be in your abode, in your mighty name of Jesus. So he said, hearken to the word of God. That is why we learned in the book of Colossians, said, let the word of God dwell in you richly and fully. Hearken to the word of God. Because when you hearken to the word of God, you prove that you are a daughter of Abraham. You prove that you are a son of Abraham. You look unto him and see that God chose him to bless him, and through him bless what? The nation. He said, for the Lord shall comfort Zion. He will comfort all our waste places. He will make our wilderness like Eden. Wow. And I desire like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness shall be found in you. Thanksgiving and the voice of melody shall be your portion. The word of God will sanctify you. The word of God will make you whole. In your mighty name of Jesus. So they cross the Jordan, because the word of God, which is the ark of God, which is also the presence of God, they put it, carried it to the middle of the water. And the hindrance is open. That tells me that in the middle of the problem, when you apply the word of God, the problems they scatter away. In the middle of the problem, when you apply the word of God, the problems they melt away. In the middle of the problem, when you apply the word of God, the hindrances they run. The Bible tells us that it says Jonah saw them and fled. Jordan saw the Israelites. when they carried the Ark of the Covenant, when they stepped into it with the word of God, he saw them and fled. As from today onward, as you sanctify yourself, as you pursue righteousness, your problems will see you, they will start running. Your problems will see you, they will start fleeing. The hindrances will see you, they will start, they will vanish in the mighty name of Jesus. Labo sherabaka satanabaya. Rivo son de loba kanderiaha. Oh, I don't know if I have time now for the Jericho war. Because after they crossed the Jordan, the Jericho war was there waiting. But there is just one thing that I don't want to say about the Jericho war. Last week we learned, he said, I will send an angel to go before you to prepare the path which you shall follow. And then later he said, I will send my angel to be before you, to drive away all those who are your enemies and cut them off and make you to reach where they expected them. Anytime you are about to face a major battle, the angel of God is assigned.
Amen.
When they were to cross the river of Jordan, the word of God, which they spoke by faith, which they believed by faith, they used it to attack the Jordan River, to prepare that way, to remove the hindrances, to scatter the stumbling block. The Bible says the Jordan fled. When it came to the time that they are going to a stronger battle, a stronger problem. I don't know that strong problem that is in your life, but one thing I know, God will assign his own angel unto you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. And it came to pass, Joshua 5:12. And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho, and we are going to start praying. You just rise up now. And it came to pass, and so I said, I want to do thanksgiving for my children. Then we go do a matter of prayer. And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho that he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, there stood a man over against him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua, I tell you, if you sanctify yourself, there will be boldness and courage in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. From 13, he said he saw this man with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went unto him. How can you see a man with sword drawn in his hand? An empty man, and yet you have the confidence, and yet you have the boldness to go and ask the person, who are you? Are you for me, or are you against me? Are you Satan the devil, or are you an angel? Are you a demon, or are you here to cause an interest unto me? Who are you? Tell me and reveal yourself so that I will know how to deal with you. Have I just said something?
Yes, ma'am.
Boldness and confidence. He went to him and he asked him. He said, "Art thou for us or for our adversaries?" And he said, "No, but as captain of the host of the Lord am I now come." There is a place of your life when you sanctify yourself and set yourself apart to prepare your own future, because you have your own work to also play. That the angels of God, not the angel that directs you in the path, but the angel that comes from his throne, will be on an assignment for you, will be on an assignment for me. That I don't even need to pray, but because God has spoken, that it will bring you to an expected end. That it will bring me to an expected end. Automatically, because we belong to God, the angels will come, and we come to do what? Be our ministry servant. And he said, I have come as the Lord of hosts to settle the matter. God will settle your matter. God will settle your matter.
Amen.
God will settle your matter. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. find a way to Jericho. I want to tell you from now onward, stop trying to reply the devil with your mouth. When the way to Jericho, stop complaining about the problems. Stop grumbling about the wahala. When they got to Jericho, the Bible said that they went around Jericho 7 days, 7 times. They went around Jericho 1 day, 1 time. 1 day, 1 time. For the 6th time. And the 7th time they went around Jericho 7 times. And the blood they dropped, they spoke, and there the word they fell. And there is no need grumbling. Use the word of God to saturate the problem. If God had allowed them to be talking, Jericho would not fall. That main battle of your life, it is not grumbling that will bring it down. That main battle of your life, it is not complaining that will bring it down. It is not murmuring that will bring it down. It is a meditating into the word of God that will make the presence of God to be with you. It's not every time. Don't need to shout. Don't need to say, I want to reply them. Don't reply your in-law. Don't reply your in-law. I repeat, don't reply your in-law. Leave them. Let God reply them. Am I talking to somebody? Stop replying your in-laws. Stop replying your in-laws. Let God reply them. If they are actually the one behind the matter, let God reply them. You be silent. Be humble in your mind towards them. Love them with the love of God. Be quiet. Don't grumble. Don't grumble about your husband. Don't grumble about your wife. Don't complain about your children. Don't grumble about your visa. Don't grumble about Austria. Don't grumble about Europe. Don't grumble. They went around Jericho for 6 times. They didn't say a word. They didn't open their mouth. They didn't say a word. On the 7th day, they went round it 7 times. And then they shouted a shout of victory. The trumpet sound. They shouted hallelujah. And the war.